To remove a front I/O panel, first remove the access panel and the front bezel. Swing up the system drive cage. Detach the front I/O USB 3.0, USB 2.0, and audio connectors from the motherboard. Pull the USB 2.0 and audio cables from the smaller cable guides on the bottom of the chassis wall. Pull the USB 3.0 cable out from the large cable guide under the drive cage area. Detach the black Torx head screw securing the front I/O panel to the front of the PC. Squeeze in on the right side of the front I/O panel and push the front I/O panel into the inside of the PC. Carefully remove the front I/O panel and its connectors from the unit. The front I/O panel has a tab on the left side that hooks over the edge of the front I/O panel cutout on the front of the PC. The front I/O panel also has a hook on the right side that snaps over the right side of the cutout. To reinstall the front I/O panel, align the left tab of the panel from the inside of the unit over its cutout. Push the rest of the panel towards the front of the unit until the right hook snaps into place. Secure the front I/O panel to the front of the unit with its black Torx head screw. Replace the USB 3.0 cable into the large cable guide under the drive cage area. Replace the USB 2.0 and audio cables into the smaller cable guides on the bottom chassis wall near the power supply. Replace the front I/O USB 3.0, USB 2.0, and audio connectors to the motherboard. Swing the system drive cage back down into place. To remove an expansion card, first remove the access panel. Remove any external connectors from the expansion card, such as wireless antennas. Detach any internal connectors to the card. Lift the latch for the expansion card's retaining bracket and swing the bracket up and out.
Press down on the latch for the PCI x16 slot on the motherboard if removing a card from the PCI x16 slot.
Pull out the expansion card. To replace an expansion card, carefully align and push the card into its slot on the motherboard until it is fully seated. Make sure any connectors are not pinched under the card. Rotate the expansion card's retaining bracket back into place to secure the card. Attach any internal connectors necessary to the card. Attach any external connectors if necessary, such as external wireless antennas. To replace system memory, first, remove the access panel. You may also want to swing up the system drive cage for easier access to the memory module area on the motherboard. Simultaneously push down on the clips on either side of the DDR4 DIMM socket to release the memory module. Carefully pull out the memory module. There is one notch on the bottom of every DDR4 DIMM module, offset from the center, that fits over a tab in the DDR4 DIMM memory socket. When installing DDR4 DIMMs, align the notch on the module with the tab in the socket. Press the module into the socket until the clips on both sides of the socket lock into place. Rotate the system drive cage back into the down position if you raised it to access the memory modules. To remove the speaker, first remove the access panel and the front bezel. Swing up the system drive cage. Detach the speaker connector to the motherboard. Free the connector from the large cable guide on the wall of the PC. Remove the two Torx head screws that secure the speaker to the front of the PC. Pull the speaker out of the unit. To replace the speaker, press the speaker onto the front wall of the PC, aligning the two screw holes on the speaker with the two screw holes on the front of the PC. Replace the two Torx head screws to secure the speaker to the front of the PC. Place the speaker connector into the large cable guide on the wall of the unit. Replace the connector to the motherboard. Swing the system drive cage back down into place. To remove an SD card reader if present in the unit, first remove the access panel and the front bezel. Swing up the system drive cage. Detach the SD card reader connector from the motherboard. Free the connector from the cable guides on the bottom wall of the unit. Detach the Torx head screw that secures the card reader to the front of the unit. Press on the retaining tab at the side of the reader and pull the reader out of the front of the unit. To replace an SD card reader, feed its connector in through the front chassis cutout for the reader. Slide the reader into the cutout until the left side retaining tab snaps into place. Secure the reader to the front of the unit with its Torx head screw. Route the card reader connector into the cable guides on the bottom wall of the PC. Reattach the connector to the motherboard. Swing the system drive cage back down into place. CMOS factory settings should be restored as a first step before replacing the system motherboard. To restore CMOS factory settings, first remove the access panel. Remove the battery from the motherboard. Wait 30 seconds. Replace the battery to the motherboard. CMOS factory settings are now reset. Note that you will now need to enter system BIOS and reset the clock in BIOS after this procedure. To remove the power supply, first remove the access panel. Swing up the system drive cage. Then detach all power connectors to the motherboard. Note, the motherboard connectors have a latch that must be pressed to release the connectors. Disengage the power connector that is routed through the cable guides on top of the heatsink shroud.
Free the two front power supply connectors from the large cable guide near the power supply.
Next, detach the three Torx head screws that connect the power supply to the PC. Press the latch at the inside edge of the power supply in the unit, and slide the power supply into the PC before fully removing it from the unit. Always replace the entire power supply. Never attempt to work within the power supply unit. There is a hook inside the PC that slides into a slot on the power supply. To replace the power supply, align the power supply slot near its hook, then slide it toward the rear of the unit until the latch locks into place. Reattach the three Torx head screws at the rear of the chassis to secure the power supply. Replace the two front power supply connectors back under the large cable guide near the power supply. Place the 4-pin power connector back into its cable guides on the heatsink shroud. Reconnect all power connectors to the motherboard. To remove the motherboard, first remove the access panel. Swing up the system drive cage. rotate the fan duct away from the heatsink shroud toward the rear of the PC. Remove any expansion cards present in the unit, the parallel port adapter or serial port adapter if present in the unit. System memory, the heatsink shroud, the heatsink, and the CPU. Detach all connectors to the motherboard. Remove the 8 screws that attach the motherboard to the PC. Pull the motherboard out carefully, making sure not to damage the solenoid lock assembly if present in the unit. Place the motherboard in an anti-static bag.
There are several clips on the side wall of the PC that help secure the motherboard in place. To replace the motherboard, carefully place the motherboard in the unit, clearing connectors from under the edges of the board and aligning the motherboard inside its clips on the bottom of the chassis. Replace the 8 screws to secure the motherboard to the unit. Replace all connectors to the motherboard.